John, it's me.
Dad is losing his mind or something. I got a phone call. There's something wrong with him. This is a crisis.
I don't think this actually qualifies as a crisis. It's an alarm.
You mean it's like we're in orange?
Exactly, but
we're in yellow, okay? So we should just be aware
and be cautious. When it hits red, then we're in trouble.
There's a moment in everyone's life.
I gained some weight.
I didn't say anything.
When childhood ends and adulthood begins. For John and Wendy Savage, that moment is now.
Hi, Dad.
Hi, Dad.
Do something! There's a doctor.
He's not that kind of doctor, Dad.
Except my boy was a doctor.
Doctor of philosophy. He teaches theater.
Like Broadway?
No, like theater of social unrest.
Looks like the Unabomber lives here.
The couch is actually pretty comfortable.
Great. Where is it?
It's a place with an opening that can take him right away.
What kind of place?
In this country, they call them nursing homes. You still there?
I got us an interview. It's called Green Hill Manor.
Sounds like an insane asylum.
You're an idiot.
Can we just play the game?
It's not funny.
We'll need to know your father's burial or cremation plans.
What kind of question is that?
Something they want for their records.
Who?
The people who run the place.
What the hell kind of hotel is it?
Fox Searchlight Pictures presents...
Maybe Dad didn't abandon us. Maybe he just forgot who we were.
A serious comedy about what happens when everyone in the family...
What do you think?
What's it do?
Nothing.
...finally starts acting their age.
You're doing the right thing, man. Taking better care of the old man than you ever did of us.
I know.
When you're dealing with dementia, you have to bring things in to stimulate their memory.
Excuse me. We haven't served the refreshments yet.
And there's a look at the Savages, which I understand you didn't mind, Gavin.
No, I really liked it, but I must admit I went with some trepidation because I thought it looked very bleak. Story of Philip Seymour Hoffman and Laura Linney, who are underachieving, troubled souls, aren't they, really? They're literary people, not really getting where they want to. They've got a very estranged relationship, and they need to go and visit dear
old... Sounds like I'm going to love it. Yeah.
Sounds based on fact, doesn't it? Who have to visit dear old dad who's losing his marbles. And they're basically going to try and get him into a home and work out what to do with him. And, of course, it does sound similar territory to that terrific movie last year, Cause Away From Her, which was was movie of the year for me. But
the way you've described this, Gav, really sounds like it could be so sentimental and just so awful because they're looking after an ailing father and they've got to come together and solve some crises, but done subtly and not
and gritty.
Sentimental.
Mm, you like that word, Andre, gritty.
Is it?
Yes, it is.
I mean, thank goodness. And look, the casting, these two are at the top of their game at the moment. You know, he's an Oscar winner, she's a nominee. Someone give her an Oscar soon, for God's sake.
She's great.
This is a terrific movie where it could have fallen down in so many ways. The script is tight, it's very good. It doesn't open them up and go, ooh, dysfunctional family, everybody peer in. But it's just a very subtle look at how dissatisfied they are with their lives without them being off the rails or anything, and just how their past and their relationship with their father has affected them.
Right.
It's terrific.
And complex characters because, like I said, they are dysfunctional, and you've seen Philip Seymour Hoffman play a dysfunctional guy several times, and actually seen Laura Linney do that too, so I was expecting some... Yeah. Dramatics and histrionics, but no, I thought really complex characters. Her motivation throughout the movie is interesting. She's not always very honest with her brother, and that's interesting. And I thought Philip Bosco, who plays Dad, you're expecting this grumpy tyrant who's going to have smart quips like Alan Arkin, you know, from the Little Miss Sunshine. No, he doesn't play it for laughs at all. He's a tragic figure. It's sad, and he's very subtle. I think a terrific performance from him. He doesn't have to say anything half the time. It's just a look in his eye while his kids are fighting over him, basically, or fighting in front of him. I think really moving. She's having an affair with a married man, But it's not glossed up at all. It's really earthy relationship.
Gritty.
Very gritty, like I said, and surprisingly...
And rather unappealing.
Surprisingly optimistic. After all what I've said, I think there's an optimistic ending to it without being pat and manipulative. Full price plus GST for me. I think quality acting. You know, this movie should have come out at the start of the year. It was Oscar nominated for screenplay and actress.
Mm.
It got shelved because it's a hard topic, and we got it 6 months later. Go out and see it. It's terrific.
Yeah, full price from me. I really enjoyed it.
Would you recommend it?
Mm. Yes, okay. I do. Well, yeah.
Did you not listen to what
no,
we
I'm
said
listening,
about it?
No, I'm just thinking one of those office water cooler recommendations.
Yeah, no, it's good.
Because I know if I recommend something like that, when people see it and they come back to me, they're just about ready to knock my lights out.
Well, it's,
you know what I mean?
It's a talky indie movie.
It's got humour as well, though. You know, you do warm to these cats.
Sounds great.
A friend of mine does some consulting for the Guggenheim Foundation. He looked your name up in the computer. You've been rejected 8 times.
So? How many times have you been rejected?
That's not the point. 6.
No. The point is, you don't think I have any talent. The point is, you called them because you just couldn't believe that your little sister might just get one of them.
That's not true.
Yeah, it is true.
No,
you know, you're just like him. He never thought I could do anything either.
Why are you comparing me to Dad?
Comparing you to...
What is the point?
No, you don't think I have any talent. You just don't think I can do anything.
You obviously don't think you can do anything either because you have to lie about it.
Are you out of your mind?
I'm out of my mind.
Yeah.